rifle and came to the city looking for food. I met Charlie right after I bagged my first Ravager. He said I was a good shot. And he's right. He called me a remnant. Just like him. And all the other survivors who fight against the Chimera. I think I like being a remnant.
Hours, the resistance fighters had surrounded and killed over 2,000 enemies. Thanks for the help, fella. Name's Ellis. This here is Glinda and Martin.
Good shooting out there.
Yeah. We could use a guy like you around here.
No doubt. But that's Charlie's call.
Away from the VTOL! I got the right side!
I'll take the left!
Till the dropships are gone.
Grenades and ammo up on the second floor.
Good. Load up. This might get a little heavy.
Ellis, this is Charlie. I'm on my way. Where are you?
We're holed up in the pub. But don't worry, we got a cover. We got a new friend here. He helped us out. Guy's a hell of a fighter, Charlie.
Get back to the hideout as soon as you can. And bring your new friend.
We'll head out as soon as the skies are clear.
Dropship coming in from the west.
Listen up. Let's hit these bastards in the streets. Keep them away from the doors. Got it?
Thank you.
That's all.
Good shooting.
Good work, everybody.
The skies are clear. No more dropships.
Now's our chance. Let's move.
Right behind you.
Hurry! Over here! Come on, this way!
Oh, hell, not another dropship.
Come on, we gotta move!
Compliment. You jealous?
Enough. Charlie will decide what to do with him once we get back to the hideout. Charlie's our leader. After the Chimera invaded, he brought all of us together. All of us remnants.
Charlie was an officer in the army.
Is that what he told you?
He wasn't an officer?
He wasn't in the army. Not officially, anyway.
That lying son of a bitch.
Charlie's father was a senator. Wanted him to go to college, study politics, all that. Charlie left home on his way to Harvard, but took a detour and showed up at Fort Benning. Talked his way onto the base, broke into the commander's office, forged some paperwork. The next day, we had a new sergeant.
That sounds like Charlie.
First.
Look out below!
Tell us, where are you?
We're almost to the hideout.
Still got that friend of yours with you?
Sure do. Big man just took out a brawler.
Did he now? Well, can't wait to meet him. He and I may have some business to discuss.
My name's Charlie Tent. You must be Joseph.
How do you know my name?
Malakoff.
Joseph.
He's been calling for you ever since we found him.
It's infected. You got any penicillin?
There's one little problem. Our only aircraft is out in the open, with no power.
What do you want?
I want a new power supply. Same kind they use in those Chimeran dropships.
Dropship, huh? That's a big job.
Life's pretty simple, Joe. We fight, or we die. I'm guessing by virtue of the fact you're still breathing, you are one of the fighting type. Like us. Am I right?
All right, here's the deal. You give the old man some pills, I'll help you take down that dropship. Then once the VTOL is powered up and he's healthy enough to travel, you give us both a ride to New York City.
You better be worth it. Now, let's get to work setting up that ambush.
Okay, let's go over the plan one more time. There's a dropship on patrol down by the river, a couple miles away. As soon as the drone sends out its signal, that dropship will come quick. Now, if any Chimera survive the crash, they'll be coming into the street over the top of that bus. We'll concentrate our fire there. Once the coast is clear, Ernie will climb over the barricade to the crash site, grab the power core, then zip his way back across the street. When it's time to move, we go through that door. Joe, release the drone. Shut that thing up, would you, Joe? Drone signals out. We got extra ammo and grenades upstairs in that building to our right. And inside Colby's on our left. Once the fighting starts, keep moving. Harder to hit moving targets. Now comes the hard part.
Here they come. That was fast.
Ernie!
Yes, I'm in!
Fight!
stop here. Watch it, Joe. If that power core is shot, it's all over. Stay close and do exactly what I say. Let's move! I've got this one over here. Catch my breath. Oh. Okay. Let's keep moving. We have to get that power cord to safety. She's killing everything in her path!
I don't mind saying, Joe, that was downright questionable for a second there. Ellis, you there?
Charlie, glad to hear your voice.
You too, pal.
You got the power supply?
Yeah.
So what's next?
I think we can make it across the rooftops.
All right, I'll send over the gondola.
People died today. I know that. But listen, it's a shitty world out there. You get to thinking too much about it, you pull yourself down. Guys like you and me, we can't let that happen. We gotta show everyone else how to live. Know what I mean? Buck up. Nobody said this was gonna be easy. My turn. Load up on ammo. Don't want you running low while you're watching my back. You are gonna watch my back, right, Joe? Grab some Molotovs, Joe. Good. Try not to set yourself on fire, okay? You clear a path. I'll follow. See that gondola moving up toward that flag? That's our way out of here. Damn it! Shock drones! They'll be coming after the power core! You gotta protect me! I'll help you! You're getting close, Joe! They're getting too close! It's no fun, Joe. Help! They're coming for me. Thank you.
go! That's how it's done. You saved my skin, Joe. Things aren't going quite the way I planned. But you're familiar with that, aren't you, Joe? You seem like a guy who's used to things going from bad to worse. God damn it! Shit! Would you look at that mess? Well, Joe, looks like you earned that trip to New York City.
Susan, Jack, they're in trouble.
It was just a dream, Joseph.
I need you to go check on my family.
What?
My wife and son, in Baxter Springs, Oklahoma.
Oklahoma?
To stick with you. We'll drop him off once we lose this dropship. Then we're off to check on your family.